please be upstanding. Welcome to the stage, the one and only, the gold medalist, the future world champion, Luke Campbell, everybody! You can move the stand if it's in your way. Alright. So ladies and gentlemen, just before we do kick this off, this Q&A, just a few things to announce. So, we was on a tight schedule because Luke had come all the way back from London and his intention was to leave after tonight's show and go back to London. In the meantime, he's had a medical family emergency and, you know, he's spent the time to come here for as long as he can and do a bit of a Q&A and then he's going to go straight back and to see his loved ones before he goes back to London again. So if we can have a big round of applause, thank you for still coming, we really appreciate it. Where's Dave? Have you managed to turn the microphone on?
I think so, Leroy.
Perfect. So Dave's going to walk around with a roaming mic. We're going to spend the next half an hour firing questions at Luke. If Luke wants to answer them, he's going to answer them. If he doesn't, he'll just mix them up, I reckon. So let's fire away, Dave. If you put your hand in the air, that'll give me an idea of who wants to answer a question, otherwise I'm going to be sat here talking to Luke for half an hour.
I'll start us off, Luke. What gives you the determination and the right attitude to continually succeed? Because from a coach's perspective, the Olympic champion and pushing on another level, what is within you to keep doing that successfully every time?
I just want to be the best, so that drives me, gets me up in the morning. I train every day to be the best I can be, and that's it really. That's as much desire I need is to get out there and be the best I can be and be the best at what I do.
Thank you. Next question.
Can I ask where you're based, please? Do you know where you're training?
Yeah, I'm based in London. My coach is Shane Wigan. And it's much better for myself being in London. Get to see my family every weekend. And, you know, I'm with the right people I should be with. And Shane's a fantastic coach. And, I'm excited for this new journey.
I'll ask you a question then. Who's your hardest fight?
I'd have to say Linares was the hardest fight. The toughest fight is probably the biggest puncher. And technique, skill, speed, he probably has all of the toughest. So I'd probably say he was the hardest fight. So up to date.
Got a question here, Leroy.
Hi, Luke. Can you tell us when your next World Championship fight is, or when it's coming up, or is it too secret?
Yeah, no, I'm just waiting on the date now. I'm hoping to fight in December on the Canelo undercard in New York City. And then hopefully after that one, we'll be looking for a world title fight in the new year.
Can I have a ticket?
Can I have as many tickets as you want?
So I've got a question over here, Dave, unless he wants to shout it, I'm not sure.
What weight do you see yourself getting put up to, or do you always want to stay at?
Yeah, I need to achieve what I'm setting out to achieve at lightweight, and then once I've achieved what I wanted to achieve at lightweight, then move on to light welter, and then do the same there. But if I leave the lightweight division now, I'd see it as a fail that I've set out to do something and I haven't achieved it. So I'll stay at lightweight until I've achieved what I wanted to achieve and then move on.
Anybody else? Don't be shy.
How
much running do I do? I run three times a week. We mainly do sprint sessions and three times a week. We don't really, you know, not no marathon runner running 5-6 miles a day. We do a lot of interval interval training, so the sprints is perfect for that.
Yeah, just down here.
Sorry, what was that?
I think the best lightweight in the world at the moment is Terence Crawford.
Well, he's actually the best light. He's actually the best welterweight in the world.
Lightweight
is
best. Call it lightweight.
He's a welterweight. He's moved up, yeah. But he beat Ricky Benz 3 years ago. He's a welterweight now.
So that was a good question 3 years ago. No, thank you. Andy, it looked like you wanted to ask something.
I was just going to ask Luke about his typical day's training. And obviously he's mentioned that.
Yeah,
but also the Lanaris, I guess now that you've obviously put the game plan into action to try to beat him. And I would just like to welcome you back as the world champion at some point in the future, Luke.
Yeah, definitely, yeah. I mean, that's the opponent I've asked for in December. So whether we'll get Lanaris is something else, but definitely asked my promoter to see if we can get Lanaris for December, get that rematch.
So, hopefully you'll have that then. Just down here, whoever's got the mic. If you feel you're loud enough, feel free to just stand up and shout them out as well. Just going to ask this gentleman here.
Luke, can you tell me who you think could win between Kell Brook and Amir Khan?
I think Kell Brook would win. I think Amir Khan's been in too many wars and took too many shots, and I don't think his durability will see him through many tough fights.
And who do you think is the greatest, in your opinion, the British boxer of all time?
British boxing of all time. The greatest all time British boxing. Maybe.
Ken Buchanan.
Forgot his name.
Ken Buchanan.
Oh?
Ken Buchanan.
There you go. I'd probably say Prince Nazim.
Prince Nazim?
Yeah, for British.
Is it Sonia who wanted to ask something? You definitely don't need a mic.
Got one here, Luke, Leroy.
1 minute, Sonia's just asking.
If you wasn't a boxer, would you be
able to any of the sports? No. I did play for Westall Rugby League for about 3 years before I decided to stop doing that for boxing, but I wasn't really good at anything else, to be honest with you. But that's probably because I didn't find my passion, I didn't find what I loved to do, and that's probably the biggest difference.
Over to Dave.
Okay.
Luke, if you could fight anybody in the world, who would it be?
If I could
fight anybody in the world, who would it be?
Probably Anthony Joshua, because you get the biggest payday.
He's got Martin down here, what's it?
As a boxer, professional boxer, what would you say is your greatest asset? And also,
what age did you realise boxing was something that you was actually quite special at?
My biggest asset in boxing, I'd probably say my dedication. And persistence
is,
just my discipline and my dedication. That's probably the last 18 years now, that's got me to where I am now. That's probably the biggest quality I have, I guess.
How old was you when you realised you wanted to
do it? I just love doing boxing, so since I started boxing at 13, and I think I won the European Championships when I was 20, so I knew when I was 20 years old that I can achieve more, and it went from there.
Did you box Leroy or are
you the star training? He said it, I didn't.
Anybody? Anybody else?
Yeah, Leroy, one at the back.
Okay.
We're just wondering, what was the best? The gold telephone box or a world title? Which one would you prefer?
Do you know, people actually believe that I own that gold telephone box, and that every 10 pence that went into that telephone box belongs to me. I'd probably say the gold telephone box.
And another one. In your opinion, Tyson Fury or Anthony Joshua?
Anthony Joshua. I think Tyson Fury has had a big layout for 2 years, and you know, he's gone through some difficult times, and I think it's hard to come back and to be on the top from having gone through what he's gone through. So I would probably say Anthony Joshua.
We've got a gentleman here at the front.
Yeah, look, the build up to a fight is actually going to the ring and surrounded by obviously your entourage and everything else. How does it feel when you get yourself through them ropes and you realise you're in the ring and that you're going to have to face and what you're going to have to do? How actually do you feel?
I try and keep a clear mind, not try and think about nothing, just try and have a clear head and just let my reactions take over. And that's what it is really, mindset.
Anyone? Just that table in front of you to the right there. If we can all just be a little bit quiet while we get the answers so everyone can hear what it is they're asking for, that would be great.
Luke, if he wants to win a world title, would you defend it in Hull?
I'd love to win it in Hull. For me, there's nothing more than being able to box for a world title at the KC Stadium, outdoors, you know, in my own city. That for me is number one, and that's what I'll be pushing for.
Just down here then.
What's your daily diet?
In training camp, daily diet is 6 days a week. I mean, clean foods, no dairy, no gluten, just clean meats and vegetables, the right carbohydrates, and maybe 5 litres of water a day. And then on a Sunday, I have a day off. I eat what I want on Sundays. Our camp is just probably just chocolate, our camp.
Leroy, we've got. She's having a glass of wine, what she has.
Hey, Will.
Hi.
What's it like to be so fit and handsome?
Well, I was asking Leroy earlier on. And he was saying it was great.
I've got a question for you. What's it like to be best mates with a lead singer of E17?
It's brilliant. We get attention everywhere we go. E17, please stand up.
Any more questions, anybody? Oh, just over here.
Yeah, look, you were talking about your diet. Do you reckon you could eat 50 boiled eggs like Lou?
51? No, never.
50 boiled eggs.
Happy boiled eggs.
So you're sober in Sonia again?
Bearing in mind that some of your school teachers are here tonight, can you tell us if you've got a favourite one?
Well, it'll come to no shock to my school teachers that I didn't really achieve in school. I tried, but it was too late. Not really.
No favourites.
No favourites.
I must say, there was one lady that approached me and she said that her claim to fame is that she was the twag lady for your school and she used to knock on your door quite a lot.
I only twagged that one lesson. That was it.
That was her claim to fame.
That was it. And I never got caught.
Any
any of your teachers say you would amount to nothing?
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of them.
Any of you tonight?
I don't know. Any of my teachers here tonight want to stand up?
Any Luke's teachers, please stand up.
Luke, you got a singing job with me. You did well.
You know, I was going to say when she said it was a Sherwood. That's
fine. Thank you very much, Luke.
I appreciate it. I got a C, so I'm happy with that.
Well done.
Thank you.
Hey, Luke. Hey. I'd like to know how you felt when you had to fight Tommy Coyle.
Beforehand or after it?
Do you think he's going to win in America?
Oh, he's fighting tonight, tomorrow. Yeah? I'm not actually sure who he's fighting, to be honest, because I think they switched opponents last minute. But he looked in great shape. So hopefully he can get the business done.
So he said he asked you how you felt when you had to fight Tommy.
Oh, I was always confident having to fight Tommy. Obviously we've known each other for a lot of years, so I always knew what I was capable of doing, and the result showed for it in itself, really.
Was the competitiveness to build the fight, or was it genuine?
I mean, he's a great talker.
Yeah.
He's a real good talker.
And how are you now? Pals again, or?
Just as what we've always been. Associates.
Yeah. Cool. Any more? Any more questions? Ahmed?
This is a sort of question and, like, I just like to talk about, but say, like, as I remember correctly, Audley Harrison was the guy who you saw who, like, inspired you to box for a winner gold medal, didn't he?
Yeah, I watched him win it, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
since 2012, obviously, Anthony Joshua was like the golden poster boy, isn't he, sort of thing, and he's transcended the sport. But you and Anthony Joshua winning them gold medals has took boxing from being like a poor man's sport in the UK to being absolutely back. It's never been bigger, I don't think. Are you proud of that? That it's really you to have done that.
It's awesome to be a part of that. I think more so Joshua that has changed the sport in itself. But yeah, boxing's growing and it's getting bigger and bigger. There's not many sports out there that sell stadiums out every weekend, not like boxing. So it's in a real good place and it's growing.
I think you're doing that, watching Audley Harrison, the next generation's watched you, and they will be saying exactly the same thing for their older.
Yeah, fingers crossed. Well, it feels like a real honour and privilege to be able to inspire the younger generation. And I've always tried to set to be a good role model.
I'm going to embarrass me and Leroy, by the way. When we watched you win the gold medal, we watched you in the semi-final and was in Hyde Park, and we both started crying when he got through to the final.
That's lovely, appreciate it.
As fellow St Paul's, just thought I'd put that in there.
Thank you.
All right, cheers.
Well, do you know, obviously you got to a final, and you had to do the final fight, was it against Nevin, for the gold medal. Was that the hardest fight from the beginning of the Olympic journey to the end?
I would probably say my quarter-final fight was the hardest against the Bulgarian. Because they was cheating me a little bit. I went out the first round, I thought I'd won convincingly, and I come back 3 points down. And then I had a great second round, thought I'd definitely close the 3 point gap, and I was still 2 points down. So it was the case of, in the end, it was just a tech one to try and give two, and I managed to win it by 1 point. But really, it should have been a lot bigger than that. But that's the judging made it the hardest fight out of the lot.
Cool. Yeah. Any more questions? Sorry, just Andy.
Finally, Luke, we've obviously got some children from the Wilberforce College here tonight, and obviously listening to yourself. Could you give them any advice, as you wasn't having the best academic student in the world, but they maybe not, they've got different talents in the arts. Any advice that you can give them children to help move them to another level in whatever they're preparing to do?
Yeah, I mean, obviously they've got different goals and different passions, but what I would say is that, you know, there's a hell of a lot of ups and downs to get where you want to get, and, you know, nothing good comes easy. So, you know, just, there's going to be a lot of downtime, so nothing's easy and a straight run. It's, you're not going to win. You know, you're going to take some losses, but it's how you get through them losses and how you keep strong-minded to be able to come out on top. So I'd say keep going, keep your head strong, keep persistent, and, you know, when the tough gets going, let's see what you've got, let's see what you're made of.
Perfect. So, ladies and gentlemen, I don't think there's any more questions, and that just leaves me to say, grab a huge round of applause and a big thank you to Luke for going out his way to be here tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for being
here.
Good to see you.